A delegation of members of parliament from the opposition led by the leader of opposition today visited Mbale city to assess the impact of the floods that rocked the city over the weekend. By the time they arrived, the search for dead bodies was still ongoing. They also visited the site where a minibus was submerged in water, killing 10 people on the spot. Many have attributed the floods to negligence of government and the police.
Disasters are about planning. Disasters are about early warning systems being in place. We came to check on the existence of early warning systems. We actually have found that some of the warnings were communicated to the regime, but of course they were preoccupied with other things.
According to the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, victims deserve justice from the courts of law.
A commandeer, a bullion van, to go and break voters in Soroti, but the same prime minister would only send 1.2 million to the community that have no food, shelter. I think really it's smoking them, and we can't allow this to happen when we are leaders in this country. They are criminal negligence. They're indictable for not doing their work when the people most need them.
The delegation delivered food items including posho and beans. Government is said to have delivered 20 tons of posho and 10 tons of beans. This was coupled with a total sum of Ugandan shillings 1.2 million to cater for the aftermath. The members of the opposition also called for the decentralization of disaster responses.
I'm very sure they have emergency tear gas. They could have had an emergency existence when these floods were raging and sweeping away people on the highways.
Over 500 households are said to have been affected by the floods that hit the Elgon region over the weekend. The most affected districts include Mbale, Sironko and Kapchora. The fire was compiled by Ramson Muhire for CTV PM Edition.